Hello, this is Wai Sun.
Hello, this is Bo Bai.
We are postdoctoral fellow with Dr. Yu Wen at the Department of Pharmacology and Pharmacy, the University of Hong Kong. Obesity is one of the significant issues in developed countries. It is strongly linked with many diseases, including diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, heart failure, liver disease, and kidney disease. This can be summarized as metabolic syndrome. In obese subjects, there are elevated levels of free fatty acid, adipokines, proinflammatory molecules, insulin resistance, and aldosterone. Aldosterone is a key hormone involved in Renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, or known as RAAS, that is important to regulate fluid and blood pressure. Excessive aldosterone production can cause kidney injury and contribute to the development of end-stage kidney failure. On the other hand, aldosterone can also modulate metabolism and energy homeostasis by acting on adipose tissues. But whether there is temporal relationship between adipose tissues and kidney in response to excessive aldosterone is not known. But what we know is that obese patients with chronic kidney disease have reduced kidney plasma flow, reduced glomerular filtration rate, increased glomerular pressure, and increased protein concentrations in urine. All these changes lead to end-stage kidney disease. Therefore, it is important to understand the mechanisms that link between obesity, metabolic syndrome, and kidney disease. In obese tissues, we know there is increased aldosterone release, as well as increased production of adipokines, such as lipocalin-2. This study aimed to investigate whether there is a link for this protein in causing kidney injury. Lipocalin-2 is a pro-inflammatory adipokine. Studies have reported that lipocalin-2 is not only a sensitive biomarker, but also contribute to the pathogenesis of kidney disease. The gene expression of lipocalin-2 is detected in loop of handle and collecting tubules. Interestingly, lipocalin-2 protein is present in proximal tubules. So this suggests that non-kidney source of lipocalin-2 protein can be collected in the kidney. We hypothesize that under pathophysiological conditions, adipose-derived lipocalin-2 causes kidney damage. To examine this, we perform a well-adapted animal model for kidney injury by removing the left kidney of the mice, administering aldosterone via a small osmotic pump, and giving 1% salt drinking water for 4 weeks. We call this treatment as ANS. We include wild-type mice, mice with complete lipocalin-2 deficiencies, mice with selective lipocalin-2 deficiency in edible tissues, as well as mice with selective lipocalin-2 deficiency in wound tumor 1 expressing cells. First, we measure lipocalin-2 protein concentrations in serum, kidney, and epididymal fat in wild-type mice. After 4 weeks of ANS treatment, we found that lipocalin-2 levels were increased. Kidney damage can be classified as glomerular enlargement, tubular damage, and fibrosis. In wild-type mice, histology showed that ANS challenge caused glomerular enlargement, tubular dilatation and swelling, as well as fibrosis. By contrast, mice without lipocalin-2 gene expression are protective against ANS-induced kidney damage in all aspects.
We also tested the levels of aldosterone-induced kidney injuries in mice with selective deletion of lipocalin-2 in adipocytes or in myelin tumor 1 expressing cells, which the later type of cells can be found in kidney. Our results show that adipo-LQ mice had partial protective effects in glomerular, but had protective effects against aldosterone-induced tubular damage, fibrosis, and inflammation. By contrast, WT1-alkyl mice did not show any protective effects in both glomerular and tubules. These results collectively demonstrate lipocalin-2 derived from adipose tissue rather than kidney cells cause tubular and fibrotic injuries in the kidney. Literatures have reported that different forms of lipocalin-2 do exist in mice and humans. Moreover, lipocalin-2 is post-translationally modified in tissue-specific manner. For example, non-polyaminated lipocalin-2 can cause endothelial dysfunction and hypertension in animals, and positively correlated with cardiometabolic risk factors in patients. These findings drive us to further investigate the effects of the different variants of lipocalin-2 causing kidney injuries, even without administration with exogenous aldosterone. We found that chronic administration with an ANS governing mutant, R81E lipocalin-2, could cause kidney injuries, resembling those observed in wild-type mice following ANS challenge. More importantly, we also detected presence of R81E lipocalin-2 in both plasma and urine samples from human subjects. After adjustment with age, smoking status, and BMI, the urine R81E lipocalin-2 and the ratio of the urine versus plasma R81E lipocalin-2 were both positively correlated with biomarkers for kidney injuries, including the KIM-1 and haploglobin.
In summary, chronic elevation of lipocalin-2, such as those produced in edible tissues, contribute to the pathogenesis of kidney injuries. This identified link can be useful for therapeutic to treat both acute and chronic kidney injuries. Thank you.
Thank you.